I should play a Phormesis. I think today I'm gonna play a Phormesis. Something that I've wanted to try since the sword changes was Phormesis with swords. Like, great swords are relatively common in the game. How many times you've seen those D6 whites with like plus 5 great swords? You can just pick up one of those and just enchant it, use it for the entirety of the game, and also use a shield, right? And just pump all of the dexterity. Hey, look at that. A perfect opportunity to ninja the orf. Of course, I would love to not have to ninja the orf, but I just hit an exploration trap. Delightful. Yeah, in case you're wondering why I am here. Cersei's malevolence fills the realm of Soth, and a teleportation trap spontaneously manifests. You're janked towards some nearby monsters, and I got placed in one of the worst positions that I could be in. This would be much easier if I had Polar Vortex or Firestorm. Shatter is not the greatest spell for this, but it is usable, certainly. Though, I can read Blinking, try to pick up the Orb. I have a port, I could try to apport the Orb. Yeah, I could try to apport the orb and then blink into one of these teleport traps. Maybe haste somewhere along the way. Probably right now. Okay. That's pretty bad. Oh boy, that's pretty bad. That was so much damage in a single turn. I was not expecting to lose more than half my HP in a single turn. But sometimes it is like that, being a deep elf. Pretty rough deep elf life. Gonna read summoning here. Gonna read another one. Pretty bad scrolls of summoning, I have to say. Thinking about the current situation, that teleport trap was pretty rough, but it was even rougher that I lost half my HP in the next turn after I teleported. I was not anticipating that. That's a good reason to have resistance to negative. The only resistance that I do not have is the one that has been consistently halving my HP with a single attack. You know, apart from Torment, but you cannot really do much about Torment. So we have a bit of an issue here. These guys hit for 45, right? And they're also fast, so even though I'm hasted, they will probably still hit me next turn. And I have two of them next to me, and I only have 45 HP. It's not like I have much HP to, you know, negotiate with. I guess you could call it negotiating. Yes, there was an item with 3 pips of resistance to negative. It was a weapon, though, so I didn't want to use it because I would have to unwield my current sky weapon, which has cold resistance, willpower, and 2 dexterity. The important part there, of course, is the cold resistance. That's why I am not using that. Yeah, also minus intelligence and minus dexterity, I think. I think I'm gonna try to drink a heal wound. So I have 20. Okay, that went well. I kind of want to port the orb now. Maybe I port the orb, pick it up, and then blink? No, that's a terrible idea. Like, if I was going to do that, I should blink first, and then apport the orb, because that delays the start of the orb run for one turn, which might be impactful. So sure. I guess I could also just kill everything. Maybe. Shatter. What if I just kill everything? They don't fly, so I can definitely kill everything. The only issue is that I would make obscene amounts of noise. That's definitely a downside. Not only that, but I know that there's some guys that are gonna be chasing after me, including an Orb of Fire and the Shadow Dragon that left me this low on HP pretty much in 2 turns. Maybe I can read another summoning here. I think another summoning is the right way to go. I have a ton of them, and like they will ideally create like a buffer so that things do not reach me, and I get like a couple of turns to either heal or apport the orb or like re-teleport or do something that doesn't involve me getting meleeed by 4 Orb Guardians at the same time. Getting some pretty bad scrolls of summoning here. What's up with this one? I think it only generated 2 dudes. I don't know if it has something to do with the fact that I already used like 2 before this one, but it's not giving me the amount of dudes that I need to receive from them right now. At least there are some monsters to ideally dilute the focus of some of these guys. Though these two guys are gonna hit me. There's no way around that. There was another play that I could have taken right as I got teleported here, and that was just reading my scroll blinking over here and trying to teleport to somewhere else. Maybe that was the correct play to go for. I'm not sure. Jeez, I got hit. Yeah, I drank heal wounds and I got hit. So heal wounds is only good if you don't get hit. If you get hit, heal wounds is gonna be trash. Tempted to use a scroll of immolation here. Is one of them berserk? No, okay, never mind. Yeah, pretty rough. I am tempted to read another teleport or another blinking. I am glad that at least I got the blinkings to, be able to run for my life here. These guys are so fast. I mean, this guy was here and this guy was here, so it's not like they moved a lot, but they're still fast enough to be able to move pretty much as fast as I do while I'm hasted. It's gonna be sketchy. I think we can swiftness here just to make myself even faster. I got marked. Delightful. Stat rot. Okay, I hope that I don't die. Delightful. I am hasted and swift, so I should be able to run. On the other hand, I think I might die. However, maybe I can fight this. How suicidal would that be to try to fight this? Like, I have Shatter. It's only a matter of drinking Brilliance and just pressing the Shatter button until everything is dead. Or I am dead, whichever happens first. Yeah, when it comes to me reading Scroll of Teleport, that hasn't really been something that I've considered, because the Scroll of Teleport is not, it's not very reliable. It would take like 20 turns to trigger, or if it doesn't take 20 turns, it feels like it takes 20 turns. If I had Statue Form, the latter would be much more unlikely for me to die. In this situation, nah, I feel like it would be equally likely, maybe even more so, because after all, the greatest defense in this game is having overwhelming offense and not having anything be able to kill you in the first place. I think I really want to fight this. The thing is that the Orbs of Fire are not gonna die that fast, and they can hit me too much. Also, the purple draconian is bad. Maybe I Fogu? Maybe I Fogu? That could be what I do. Fogu into heal wounds, brilliance? Fogu, heal wounds, brilliance, maybe? And then just shatter? The purple draconian doesn't fly, right? Yeah, it doesn't fly. The one that does fly is the black one. Black draconians fly. Those are the only ones that fly. Doesn't kill Orb of Fire and Dragon? No, Shatter kills everything. The thing is that Shatter takes a while to kill everything. Yeah, I think that's what I'm gonna do. Fogu, heal wounds, brilliance, and then you shatter everything. Let's go for it. Pretty good so far. Let's see what we got. Yeah, I'm okay with that. I am not gonna say that I am healthy, because I'm barely above 100 HP. On so many more characters, I would be terrified if I was barely above 100. But on this character, it's almost at full HP. Look at that, it's like 80%. you know how it is. I got hit by a pretty bad teleport trap. Also, I tried to teleport and I got dropped here, so, like, yeah. At this point, it's pretty hard for my character to survive. But yeah, that's just how it is with this game. I'm gonna try to survive, and I think I have a decent chance. That's why I'm going for Shatter. Let's see how it goes. My first casts of Shatter are definitely very exciting. This Orb of Fire isn't even hurt. Okay, I'm killing things. Killing a lot of things, apparently. Because Shatter, in case you don't know, hits even if you don't see things. If you have Scroll of Fogu and you Shatter, it hits the things that are beyond the Fogu. Shatter is kind of broken like that. Yeah, something that you probably didn't know about Shatter. I was taking this into account when I went for the play that I went for. Also, wow, that didn't feel like 46 damage, you know? That felt like 100. Wow, dude. Wow, that's crazy. Okay, got pretty lucky with the heal wounds there. Really, really lucky. I kind of want to irradiate. Does that work with Cobalt? I don't think it works with Cobalt. No, with I think Shatter's maximum range is your normal line of sight. Yeah, I'm thinking about Irradiate here. Just irradiating until the Orbs of Fire die. The Shadow Dragon is destroying me. I think Potion of Resistance doesn't give resistance to negative. Let's see, I have one of those. Potion of Resistance. Yeah, it doesn't give resistance to negative. It's such a rough thing. I don't know why it doesn't give resistance to negative. Okay. Yeah, Irradiate is probably the way to go here. Okay, the Shadow Dragon is next to me. That's a pretty good thing, because the Shadow Dragon being next to me means that I can kill it with Irradiate. Okay, the Shadow Dragon is no longer next to me. Now I have a Berserk Quicksilver Dragon that can pretty much destroy me. In a single turn, if I get unlucky. 25 and 20. Hmm. Considering that this guy is almost dead, though it does fly, I am very compelled to shatter, because the it radiate damage would only deal damage to these two guys, and one of the main things for me to kill is this Shadow Dragon. And also, I think Shatter would just straight up kill the Quicksilver Dragon. Just out of curiosity, I want to see how much damage my Shatter deals. Three dice of 54. That's a lot of damage. Pretty good. I think I'm gonna go for another Irradiate. Okay. Amazing, dude. That was incredibly rough, but we're doing well. I'm gonna continue shattering, of course. Yeah, Shatter is really good against Orb Guardians. Okay. Funny dispersal trap effects. Crystal Spear. Two Orbs of Fire. Delightful. Okay, got rid of one Orb of Fire. Even more Orbs of Fire, apparently. I got Berserkitis, but considering my current character, Berserkitis doesn't do anything. I have not meleeed for the entirety of the stream today, so I can tell you for sure that Berserkitis doesn't do anything. I have minus swiftness. My swiftness ran out. Important thing to remember because I cannot really run away now. I would need to blink away. I don't think it's okay, but it's nothing that I immediately want to, remove mid-combat. So this epic SOT 5 fight has been mostly sponsored by the ridiculous amount of potions of heal wounds that I did get in this playthrough. Yeah, shouts to that. Oh wow, Yellow Draconian just killed my Servitor. With a bit of luck, I'll be able to rest here. Okay, there we go. Yeah, we're fine now. Dude, that was crazy. Did you see that? That was insane. I thought that I was gonna die. Like, yeah, that was much more likely to kill me than the Cursed Toe situation from earlier, where I was confused at 40 HP, and I also thought that I was gonna die there. Yeah, hello Railbird. If you just arrived, you just missed me surviving an exploration's trap inside here. Like, this has to be like one of the most unavoidable exploration traps in the entire game. I feel like every character has to go through this room. I just went here, and it triggered, and it dropped me here, and I went over here. I walked over here, and that teleport trap put me over here. So yeah, it's been like an experience. I am probably gonna put that on YouTube because I feel very happy about the result that we got. It was actually insane. Okay, I think I can turn that off. Maybe train ice magic for polar vortex. Not that I would get it anyway. All right, let's drink potions of mutation. Let's see if we can get rid of some of these very bad mutations. That's good. I'll take that. I'll take that. My armor class went up a fair amount. I gained two armor class and I also lost the formed body mutation that re subtracted some armor class. Okay, the Orb of Salt is right here, but I don't feel like picking that up immediately. That was a fight of epic proportions. Yeah, I feel very happy how that about how that went. I hope that I don't get killed by the Ancient Leech. Funnily enough, the Ancient Leech cannot really one-shot me, but it can come pretty close to doing that. Okay. Sorry, there he is getting in again. I hope that it's not hitting the microphone. I think we're done with Sot. Oh boy, that was an experience. Yeah, it's the opposite of what I normally like to do when I go to Sot. You know, I try to kill everything and go like work my way in, and then just not have to deal with such massive bands of monsters. Yeah, nice recovery. It was insane. Let's get out of here. I earned this win. I definitely did. Panlord. Oh, BB was here. Should I go out of my way to kill BB? I guess I'll do that. Not a lot of evasion. Chain lightning, though. Sleep. 0% chance to sleep. It flies, so Shatter won't really do a lot against this guy. I'm gonna drink a potion of brilliance and a potion of haste. I have two of them now. I'm gonna cast a servitor. How much damage do you deal? 3 dice of 37. Okay, that's a lot of damage. Gonna phantom mirror the servitor. Now I have two servitors that can shoot crystal spears. Pretty good. There we go. Hopefully my buffs will stay with me for the BB fight. It's so far away. I hope that I do manage to get there while still having my things. And just as I say that, the purple draconian immediately appears from around the corner with no counterplay whatsoever, just removes my buffs. That sucks. Not gonna use haste for BB. I'm gonna use brilliance just because I have so many of them. Haste is much more valuable in the orb run. Okay, I have refrigeration. I don't know if I should refrigeration. I am going to refrigeration. Hello, BB. BB the Exile. Let's take a look at the tile for BB again. Pretty cool tile, right? Yeah, I like the tile. I don't play tiles, but it's a pretty cool tile. Clean up Sot before orb run. I guess so. But I got shafted, and then when I came back up, I stumbled upon BB. Also, on the opposite side of the level, there was an orb of fire and a scroll of acquirement. I guess I'm also gonna go out of my way to pick up that acquirement just to know what it had. And BB dies from two shatters because shatter deals a crazy amount of damage to monsters like that. You fly now, so I'm just gonna cast a servitor and walk in the opposite direction. Crystal spear hits the Deva. Another Panlord. Huh. This one has summon greater demon. It doesn't fly. How hard do you hit? 38. No brand. Yeah, it's not scary. Not scary, as I mentioned. There we go. Let's go get that scroll of acquirement. That's a pretty good ring. Ring of Pessimism. I would like to use that on so many characters. That's like a godly ring for a melee character, because it gives armor class and slaying. Yeah, pretty cool ring. I'll get the ring and I'll inscribe it with. I would be pretty optimistic if I happen to stumble upon this ring. I cannot carry that many items. Okay, something will have to go. I guess we can get rid of the Kirari darts. Yeah, there we go. Oh, it has a cap. I typed ring and it stopped at ring. Okay, well, that's fine. Go D0. Get me out of here. My business here is done. If it summons Brimstone Fiends and Hell Sentinels, then it becomes a scary. Yes, but I also took that into consideration, and I was fighting it in a position where even if it summoned things, I wouldn't be able to see those things, because I was only really able to see the Panlord. Yeah, fighting in those positions is very important whenever you're fighting something that can summon. Inscriptions are not so robust. What would you do to inscriptions to make them better? Just like out of curiosity. Oh, I skipped this level. I think this level had, well, to begin with, two orc wizards, a priest, and an ogre on D5 all together is a pretty good reason to skip the level. Oh, whoa, stop that. This would be the time where I would cast or use Holy Word if I had it. Holy Word no longer exists, however, so I'm forced to use Refrigeration, which is scary, but it does get the job done. Another Fiend. Lots of greater demons this run. Yeah, Hell Sentinels and Fiends and Executioners. Let me tell you that for this character, Executioners are not nearly as terrifying as it would be for a different character. This character was unusually robust for a deep elf. I have a 24 armor class. Yeah, and it's crazy that I have 24 armor class because I don't have any training in armor. And I also, like, I only have fully enchanted armor, pretty much. That's all that there is. So it's crazy.
My wife still doesn't believe in me!
Hey, Salt and Plum, thank you for the subscription. I appreciate it. I am glad to see that you've been liking my content so far. Yeah, thank you so much. I appreciate that. By the way, I would like to ask, how did you stumble upon my channel, Salt? In case you don't know, I have like a YouTube channel with like a ton of content if you are interested in watching that. Yeah, I think we're done with this character. Overall, I would say that it was a pretty good character. And you want to know why it was good? I had resistances and good damage output from the very beginning of the game. You were looking up Crow on YouTube and found me there about a week ago? I see. It was a good decision to to start uploading things to YouTube. For like the first half a year or so of my stream, maybe more than that, I was like completely ignoring YouTube. Like I was not uploading anything. I didn't really have a YouTube. Eventually I started uploading, but like I always had the idea that I was not gonna do like those highly edited 10-minute resumes of interesting things that happened that you can see in another like YouTube channels, obviously not crawl oriented YouTube channels, but like I could have done that for crawl, but I chose not to do so because I didn't think that it was going to be doable. You know, there's so many things that happen in a crawl game that it's like impossible to condense into 10 minutes. So yeah, I do apologize for uploading 5-hour videos and so, but I feel like that's the correct way to do it. You found the inscriptions and items very inconsistent across all of the items. You tend to log all of your kills and ascend with the loot from Ling Uniques, and sometimes you find items have the different inscription caps. Caps? Hmm. You're having the full playthroughs available on YouTube. I'm glad to hear that, Wormbird, because I have no plans to stop doing that. You know, it's pretty good to have them on YouTube like that, in that long play format, because you can speed up the video if you don't want to, like, watch a 5-hour video. You just speed it up to 1.5 or 2 speed, and it's much more digestible like that. So, yeah, another win. I wonder how many wins I have right now. Let's get out of here. Easy game. 5 hours, 5 hours and 21 minutes. Fast for a spellcaster, and very strong for a summoner. Yeah, good stuff. Good stuff. That went very well. Let me check real quick how many wins I've had. I have to ping a couple of accounts in order to find out, because I have 3 accounts. Okay, so it says that I have 137 in the Nine Settler account, plus 90 in my first account, plus 11 in the Nine Settler 2 account, and I have a total of 238 wins. Nice. I might want to do something for like 250 wins or so, but more likely than not, I'm just gonna leave it for 300 wins. It's crazy. I never thought that I was gonna get to that amount of wins. I remember back in the day when I saw people with like 50 wins or so, and that felt so unattainable, but it's just as easy as a change of perspective. It's not about accumulating wins, it's about having a fun time with the game. And if you're having a fun time, the wins are just gonna come on their own, given enough time. So yeah, I liked how that went, especially that sword fight at the end. That was one of the most exciting things that I've done on stream in a while. Yeah, let's go ahead and start a new one. I did say that I wanted to play a Formiseith of Dexterity. So Formiseith. I feel like I have to go for a fighter, but I'm not so compelled to do that. But fighter starts with a shield. It's like a buckler nowadays, right? It's a buckler nowadays. But it's a shield at the end of the day, and I'm a Formiseith. But how much dexterity am I going to start with? Monk could also be okay, but monk can be terrible. I'll start a monk just for the dexterity. Falchion. Rumored to be powerful enough to resurrect a god. Interesting flavor text. Let's go back to tiles, of course, because the vast majority of people don't understand what's happening with console. All the micro decisions are really great to learn from. Yeah, that's my goal at the end of the day. I stream in such a way that I like try to describe all that's going through my head while I'm playing Crawl as best as I can. And I feel like that's a pretty good way for people to learn from that. So yeah, I'm glad to hear from people who watch that content that it does work for them, because like I put it out there with that goal in mind, but I don't know if it's actually achieving that goal until someone comes here and tells me, hey, this is working for me. So yeah, pretty important to hear that.